students, welcome to the English class. Today we are going to learn grammar. In our previous grammar video, we had learned about the describing words. So what did we learn about the describing words? The words which give us more information, or we can say the words which tell us about some object, some place, some person, some animal, they are called as the describing words. For example, let me take a sentence. Geeta is a beautiful girl. So, Geeta is a girl. We come to know that Geeta is a girl. But I said Geeta is a beautiful girl. So, the word beautiful is describing Geeta. And so, the word beautiful is called as a describing word. Similarly, if we speak about some place, suppose Kolhapur. So, what do we say? Kolhapur is a big city. So, we all know that Kolhapur is a city. But the word big is telling us that Kolhapur is a big city. It is not a small one. But how is it? It is very big city. So, the words that give us information about the person, place, animal, birds, objects are called as describing words. Today, we are going to learn the topic describing animals. So, in this topic, we are going to learn about the words which are used to describe the animals. All the animals, maybe domestic animals, wild animals. Okay, so on the board, you can see some of the words. So, these words are the describing words. And these words and many more are used to describe the animals. So, first, let us read these words. So, the first word is N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty. Yes, what is the meaning of naughty? Naughty means mischievous. Keeps on doing some or the other thing which troubles others. The next is long, L-O-N-G, long. So, we can use this word long for the snake. Yes, the snake was very long. The next is tall, T-A-L-L, tall. So, the animals which are having a greater height like giraffe, we can use this word tall for giraffe. The next is strong, S-T-R-O-N-G, strong. So, the animal who is having great power, for that animal we can use the word strong. Like lion, tiger, leopard. Yes, for them we can use the word strong. The next is weak, W-E-A-K, weak. So, strong is the opposite of weak. So, the animals which are not strong enough, for those animals we can use the word weak. The next is short. The animals which are not very tall, which are having a less height, can be called as short animals. The next is thin. We can use the word thin, fat. Yes, fat means very big and thin means very, very thin. So, the next is hard. So, for the word hard can be used for the describing the skin type or for describing the hair texture. Yes. The next is huge. Huge means very big. We can use the word huge for animals like elephant. Elephant is a very huge animal. Similarly, hippopotamus, it is also a very huge animal. Yes. The next is soft. S-O-F-T, soft. So, the word soft can be used to describe the rabbit because the rabbit is having very soft hairs, very soft fur. Similarly, the colors like grey, black, white, brown, they can be used when you are describing the animals and they are having these colors to them. The next word is timid. Timid means very frightful. Timid is the word which can be used for a rabbit. Yes, it is very fearful animal. So, these are some of the words which we can use to describe the animals. Now, I will be showing you a small clip in which I will show you exactly how to use some of these words to describe the animals.
Can you see this picture? What animals can you see in this picture? Yes, the first animal we can see here is a elephant, and below the elephant you can see a rabbit. Okay, besides the elephant there is a monkey who is eating a banana, and below the monkey you can see a lion. Also, besides the lion and the monkey, we can see a giraffe. So students, these are some of the animals that we see around us. Now, let us use the words which are given above to describe these animals. So, what is describing? Describing means telling or giving information about the object or any person or any animal. Now let us describe these animals by using the words given above. So first we will describe an elephant. So the name of this elephant is Jumbo. And how is Jumbo? Jumbo is a huge animal. Huge means very big. So Jumbo is a huge animal. And what is the color of this animal? It is gray. So what can we say about this elephant? We can say Jumbo is an elephant. He is a huge animal. He is gray in color. Okay, the next we will speak about the monkey. And you know that the monkey is a very naughty animal. So we can say the monkey is a naughty animal. He loves bananas. Okay, the next we will talk about the rabbit. And you all know how is a rabbit? A rabbit has a very soft fur. What is fur? Fur are the hairs of the rabbit. So the rabbit has a soft fur, or we can say the rabbit has a soft coat. The next animal we will speak about is the lion. And the lion is the king of the jungle. And how is a lion? A lion is a strong animal. So the word strong describes the animal. And that is why strong is a describing word. The next we will speak about the giraffe. So we can say that the giraffe has a long neck. So the word long describes or tells us about the neck of the giraffe. Also we can say a giraffe is a tall animal, isn't it? So the words like long, tall, they give us information about the giraffe. So the words naughty, long, tall, gray, soft, strong, huge, these words describe the animals. So they are called as describing words.